An economist blames government's unnecessary and confidential expenditures for the country's new record high debt. Economics professor Winnie Monson says the government is spending too much in comparison to its revenue. Despite this, Monson believes the country's current debt-to-GDP ratio is not yet alarming. She admits, though, it can be a cause of concern soon if the trend of having secret funds will persist in government.
Ngayon, ang debt natin is maybe about 64-65% of GDP. Hindi nakakabahala, pero you want to pause and say, because the rule of thumb is that the debt of the country should not be more than 60%. Yung pang for safety, yung utang tayo. Kasi yung expenses ng gobyerno and the revenues of the government, hindi nagkakatugma, palagi tayo nagde-deficit. Are these expenses of the government necessary or not? Confidential expenditures of the government, of the president, or the confidential expenditures of the vice president. We can say that those are really unnecessary because, and therefore we should not spend them. And if we do not allocate that to the president and the vice president, we will have less tomorrow.
The Philippines' national debt hits a new record in August. Data from the Treasury Bureau show financial obligations inched up to 14.35 trillion pesos from the 14.24 trillion in July. The Bureau points to the weaker peso for that higher debt. This as government borrowings from foreign sources grew nearly 3% in August. Despite that, Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno says the debt-to-GDP ratio for the first half has actually declined.
As of the first semester of 2023, the debt-to-GDP ratio is at 61%, lower than the full-year target of 61.4%. And with our deficit program down to 6.1% this year and 5.1% next year, we are confident that we will be able to achieve the medium-term fiscal framework's near-term target of reducing our debt-to-GDP ratio to below 60% by 2025, if not earlier.
For next year, House Appropriations Panel Vice Chairperson Stella Quimbo said government will borrow some 2.4 trillion pesos more to partly fund the 5.7 trillion pesos spending plan. Philippine legal experts call for new laws on auditing confidential funds given to local governments. Their suggestion comes after it was revealed Vice President Sara Duterte already had billions of pesos in confidential funds when she was still Davao City Mayor. RJ Cruz reports.
Davao City's confidential fund grew from 144 million in 2016 when Vice President Sara Duterte became mayor to 460 million by the time she stepped down, or a total of 2.6 billion pesos in 6 years. A huge amount raises eyebrows.
Bakit umabot sa 460 million per year, no? Ang kidating mayor Sara Duterte sa Davao, samantalang yung ibang mga malalaking LGUs din, Makati, Manila, Cebu, ni hindi umabot sa 100 million. Eh, mapapatanong ka talaga, bakit? Ano bang meron sa Davao? Eh, inaagaw din ba yan ng China tulad ng sa West Philippine Sea? So talagang ripe for study.
Duterte's use of surveillance money is in the spotlight after the just concluded budget hearings showed her office spent 125 million pesos in just 19 days in 2022. But an ally of the Vice President, Senator Ronald De La Rosa, who is a former National Police Chief, believes the matter is being used for politicking.
Exploit lang ito ng kalaban na gamitin para palakihin ang isyo. Ganap sila ng ebidensya na ito'y ibinulsa. Pero ngayon, masyadong maingay at hindi lang oposisyon, pati na rin yung mga pupwedeng magiging piktado sa pagtakbo ni Vice Mayor Indesara sa bilang pangulo sa coming election.
Walang bumanat sa confidential funds ni dating VP Lenny dahil wala siyang confidential funds. At yung pagbanat ngayon sa confidential funds ni VP Sara ay hindi pagbanat sa personahe ni VP Sara. Pagbanat siya dun sa sobrang laking at wala sa lugar na confidential funds.
De La Rosa explained that the OVP only had 19 days before the end of the year to spend the confidential fund. Otherwise, it would revert to state coffers by year-end. Retired Supreme Court Justice Adolfo Ascunag urges the passage of a law governing the audit of confidential and intelligence funds. Ascunag believes it's better to publish redacted audit reports than not having any report published at all. He also believes the executive should provide more details when it pitches the budget.
There should be a law that will define the procedure for auditing confidential funds. Maybe the COA can propose or draft such a law. Dapat sabihin niya kung anong purpose itong confidential funds na ito. Kaya yung COA naman, maaaring tingnan kung talagang sinunod yung purpose ng confidential funds.
The COA previously revealed that aside from 57 national government agencies and 10 state companies, about 1,707 local government units also access surveillance funds. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippines expected to grow the fastest in 2023 among developing economies in East Asia and Pacific, beating Vietnam even after the World Bank slashed its forecast for the country. Jackie Pascual reports.
After the Asian Development Bank trimmed its growth forecast for the Philippines from 6 to 5.7% this year, the World Bank, too, has lowered its annual growth projection for the country from 6% in June to 5.6% in October. The global financial institution cites the economic slowdown worldwide, elevated inflation, and growing debts of many countries.
The big concern has been slowing global growth. Philippines, like all the countries in the region, depends on the rest of the world for its exports of both goods and especially services. And also, a lot of Filipinos work abroad and send their remittances back.
The forecast is also lower than the Philippine government's target of between 6 to 7%. Even Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno has said that the government may revisit its growth targets this year. Despite that, this 5.6% growth projection for the Philippines is still among the fastest in East Asia.
We expect economic activity to be supported by domestic demand, to be led by private consumption, and the decelerating inflation is good news.
The Philippine Franchise Association is also optimistic of growth driven by the pent-up demand domestically, saying total revenues of the industry could rise by 10 to 13% this year or hit at least $33 billion for 2023.
2023, we can start seeing things recover, especially in the food sector. Retail naman has been recovering. Next year, we see some of the services at least opening up.
We really feel that we are going to grow, especially with this last quarter of the year. We believe that there are more Filipino brands that will go abroad.
But the officials admitted there will still be challenges, such as the high prices of raw materials and low agricultural output, which also affect many of franchise firms' supplies.
All of us are trying to absorb a lot of the price increases, but there's only so much you can do. Inflation, everything's rising, right? Whether it's gasoline prices, whether it's a lot of the input materials, whether it's agricultural materials.
The support of the government, we badly need support to the agricultural sector, really, to be able to provide that. Increasing their production, the yield, and to be able to allocate more for production.
The group is hopeful the upcoming Franchise Asia Expo, which will be hosted by the Philippines this month, will give a boost to the local economy. About 1,000 brands globally will gather in Pasay City, and organizers hope it can entice more Filipino brands to go overseas. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippines' sovereign wealth fund expected to be operational by the first quarter of 2024. That's according to Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno, who said he will soon be submitting a list of suggested candidates for the Maharlika Investment Corporation to President Marcos. Diokno said the fund will first focus on its investments on flagship infrastructure projects. Earlier, he put to rest rumors he was being eyed to become the president and CEO of the MIC. He will serve as the ex-officio chairman of the fund's board.
The list of candidates for three positions, the president and CEO of the council, the two regular directors and three independent directors, that has been prepared already, and it will probably be sent to the president within the week. Okay. So once we have organized, and I think that will take another quarter, then maybe we'll be off and running maybe first quarter of next year. Yeah.